Do you want to know how to do a mask transition in Filmora 9 that looks just like this? In today's video, I'm going to give you a step-by-step tutorial with some really useful tips so that you can do this in a quick and simple and effective way. Let's talk about it. A mask transition is one of many types of transitions that can be used to essentially transport the viewer from one location to another, or it can just be used to cut between two different camera angles or from a wide shot to a close-up shot. It works best if your two shots have some kind of movement in the same direction and of a similar speed, but we can always adjust this in the post-production editing process. For this to work, you need to have some kind of object in the foreground that will seem like it's passing completely across the frame as you move your camera. So the object will start on one side of the frame, and as you move the camera, it will seem like it's crossing across the frame. You could essentially use any object, but in Filmora 9, it is kind of a bit tricky to do the mask transition. So it does work best if your object has a kind of straight edge. For example, a tree is a really, really good object and very easy and simple to make a mask transition for. If you used other objects like a car or somebody walking past, it is still possible, but it would take a few extra steps, which I will not go into in today's tutorial. Okay, so let's jump into my laptop and I will give you the step-by-step tutorial. So I've got my first clip here with the tree that will pass across the frame, and we're just going to drag it into the timeline as normal. And then what you want to do is find the part where the tree just starts crossing across the frame. In my example, the tree is moving from the right-hand side of the frame to the left, so I want to find the part where the background behind the tree starts showing on the right-hand side. Here you can see it's already too much, so we're going to go back a little bit and we're going to try and find the exact moment. What you could do is stretch out the timeline all the way by clicking and dragging on it, or using the plus and minus area over here. And then if you are not selected on the clip, if you have clicked somewhere else on the timeline, you can just use your arrow keys on the keyboard and we will find the exact part. So you can see just here is where the background starts showing. So I'm just going to cut the clip by using the scissors icon, or you could use Control B on your keyboard. So now you have your two parts of the clip. You're just going to ignore the first part for now and we're only working on the second part. What you want to do then is go to sample colors and select the green color. Now you should be careful, because if you have a lot of green in your clip, maybe using the green screen one isn't ideal, but for me the green here is quite dark compared to this very bright green screen. So I'm just going to drag that in. As you can see, it is now covering the whole clip, so we are going to select the green screen just by double clicking, and you can either just drag it or use the arrows to move it over. So I'm just going to move that right over, and then I'm going to use my arrow keys for more precise movement, just so it covers that small bit of the background behind the tree. Then you could go to the next clip just by clicking the next frame, or again, if you click somewhere else on the timeline, you can use the arrows to skip through the different frames. What you want to do on the next frame is cut the green screen. It doesn't really matter if you cut the bottom clip as well, that's fine. And then we're going to double click on the green and use your arrow keys for that precise movement to move it so it's covering the whole background behind the tree. Again, just go to the next frame and the same thing, you're going to cut the green screen and again just move it over. And we will keep doing this frame by frame. It does take quite a long time, but you will see that when you go through the different frames, you will see the tree and the green screen appear to be moving together. So when you come to the last few frames of this, you might need to really increase the size of the green screen and adjust the angle again, and just make sure that it covers absolutely everything on the right hand side on the background of the tree. And just keep going until the tree is completely off the frame like this. So this is my last frame that I will cover with the green screen. Then when you've finished and you've covered the very last frame with the full green screen, just make sure that you stretch out this green screen quite a bit further, because you might need well, you don't need to go that far, but you might need to use the extra part of the green screen for the next clip. So in the end, you're going to have something that looks like this with the green screen and the tree moving together. And all you want to do is then just export this whole file and we will re-import it into a new timeline. Then you want to essentially reset the timeline, so just delete everything in the timeline. And then you will import the green screen clip that you've just made and also the second clip that you want to transition to. We're just going to drag these both onto the timeline and you're going to find the part where the green screen starts coming through or even just before, and we will put the second clip underneath this clip. This is very important. Now if we go a bit forward to where you can see the green screen and click on this top layer and then go to where it says chroma key, make sure you select that, and just to be extra sure you can always click the eyedropper tool and hover over the green to make sure it's correct. Now sometimes the edge might look a bit strange, so you could play with the edge feather and change all these settings, the edge thickness and so on. For now I'm just going to leave it how it was. So if we play this through, you will see that the second layer starts showing through the first layer. So that is essentially the transition. Now if you do want to make it a bit less noticeable, you could always adjust the speed by cutting the clips and clicking the speed button here. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions or any problems while doing this, and I will try my best to help out. And also don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and click the subscribe button just below if you want to see more videography videos, tips, tricks, and tutorials like this. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!